gonna do a little video about how I go through clips and organize them. As you can see, my screen's broken, but my camera's now on. I'm gonna push the second button to get it into playback mode. Now I'm going to hold it down until it goes into USB mode. Then I'm going to connect my USB to the USB 2.0 port. Okay, now I'm going to make a new folder for the day we went skating. And it's going to have the date as well as the spot we went to. Just like a general location, and if there's anyone, like specific people who tried tricks, I'm gonna put their names down too, just so that when I'm trying to search it up later, I can find whatever day I'm looking for. Alright, my trackpad is kind of broken, and I can't use my USB mouse because I only have two USB inputs, so I kind of have to do it kind of a janky way, but I'm gonna open right click. I'm gonna try to right click my camera. And then I'm gonna go here. And then when you get to the AVCHD, you have to right stream. It'll just have all your clips laid out, and this is just how you do it on the HMC. I think like most of the other Panasonic cameras kind of have a different you have to actually capture the footage, like kind of similar to a VX, but on the HMC it'll have every time you stopped and started the camera, it'll be a different clip. So then what I'm gonna do next is I'm gonna just do main A and then select all of those, and then I'm just gonna copy them or drag and drop, and then just drop them into my labeled folder with the date and location. And it will probably take a little bit, so we're just gonna listen to some music and watch some videos in the meantime. Alright, now that I have all my clips imported, I'm gonna create three new folders. First one's gonna be good, and then second is heat, and third is good. Alright, so now that I have these three folders, I'm basically gonna go through all of these and sort of figure out where they go. And usually what I try to do is I try to mark stuff in camera just so you can know. Like, just from looking at all these, I can see a hand right there, so I know that that should be a good clip. But everything else before it, if there's no sort of mark, I can assume that it's nothing I need to make a video. Alright, so I'm just gonna delete all of those. But the reason for the delete folder and not just throwing it in the trash bin is because let's say you go through everything and then you can't find a clip, and then luckily you didn't delete it, it's just in that folder. But when you do need to clear out storage, you can easily, you know, triple check it and then delete the delete folder when you need to free up some storage on your hard drive. All right, so this is the first clip I have marked. Take a look at it. I think it's I Alright, so that's a pretty good clip. I think I might use it for a video. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to put it in the good folder. Then I'm just going to keep on going through these, selecting these clips that don't have any sort of mark or indication that they're good. I'm going to continue deleting these. This one, it does have a, you may notice that this one has a fist, not a hand. And usually, if it has a fist and not a hand, that is to indicate that it's maybe something like good, something like I might be able to use for something, but maybe not like a clip for a big video. Yeah. So that one will probably go in the keep folder. Probably not going to use that for anything, but it's good just to have it. And then again, the keep folder is kind of going to be any sort of video you want to keep, or like you want to be able to watch it later, but you're not using it in a big video or anything. All right, now that I have all my footage organized into these three folders, I am going to format my memory card by clicking the menu button. And then, let's see, scrolling down till we get to card functions, format. Yes. The sound of my clips sending out just now. And all right, now that that's formatted, we're going to turn this off, and I'm gonna charge my battery for tomorrow.